Hi everyone, welcome to Alternavita, where I'm hoping I can keep my voice through this video. Going to be a casual video today for numerous reasons. It's 20 till 9 and I've already been sitting here for 2 hours trying to complete a post and having already spent 3 hours this weekend hoping that I could advance the story and running into the same old dilemmas that I always run into. Namely, I would like to share some new things. I would like to write about some new things. But then I have to spend hours editing someone else's video to eliminate things that simply aren't true. So I can take all that time, or I can just throw the baby out with the bathwater and present the entire video. Hope it doesn't lead to more confusion, which I do not like to do. And try to present, hope that people can wade through it and come out with something they can actually practically use in their everyday life to improve their condition. And it's just getting old. I'm just tired of it. So, last week I presented the updates on fecal microbiota transplants. It's been 37 years in the making. And they've still gone relatively nowhere. I told you that what is going to be elevated to the top of the list as far as common traits, and that would be fiber. And fiber is the poster boy. You know, I pretty much confirm that everywhere, that, you know, it's out there. Just increase your fiber and everything will be okay. Well, that's been refuted. It's been thoroughly refuted that it does not improve the immature status of the microbiota in children who were not breastfed and then fed high fiber, nutrient dense foods, and it did not reverse the status of the poor formated microbiota. So I would like to I would like to share a clip from Dr. Robert Lustig where he introduces the importance of the microbiota. He reiterates how with just one simple change of eliminating added sugar, keeping the carbs, keeping the starch, the particular diet isn't especially nutritious. In fact, it's pretty much junk. And yet, the metabolic profile began to change almost immediately. Now, I think that's a very important development. I think it's important for me to help advance this story because I know that there are some conditions that could happen to people, whether they are breastfed or not. And those conditions would be diabetes, cancer, and cancer. So I wanted to share the entire video. And here I run into the same issues. He claims that vaccines are one of the most important developments in the history of the world. Already it's refuted. Ignores the evidence from the WHO. Ignores the evidence from Israel. Ignores the evidence about the dangers of injections in general and going via the systemic route, via the gut and lymphatic gulp system, and how one is safe and one is dangerous, and having major implications for IBD malignancy and autoimmune conditions and chronic inflammation. So I'm not going to put that out there because that ignores the evidence. I'm not going to put it out there that fiber will change everything because I already know that's not true. It ignores the crucial first year of life. That also ignores the evidence from the WHO of chronic top risk factors in hierarchical order. So that's always my dilemma. Do I spend hours upon hours editing things to share something new and advance the story, which I would like to do? I understand that certain processed foods are outside of the timeline of when not breastfeeding became the norm. And that would be rice and sugar. And they had major impacts on people's health and nutrition regarding like beriberi and diabetes. Those are processed foods that have been in existence for thousands of years, hundreds if not thousands of years. And it's important to understand the impacts of those two foods alone. So that's where the problem that always occurs, you know. I want to share new developments. I want to share crucial information that's outside of this particular caused conditions. And yet, I just have to keep editing people so much that it takes too much time. And then I just end up repeating the same old things anyway. So it gets to you after a while. Let me put it that way. But you know, why they do this, I understand that people have their own agendas. People have their own viewpoints. People have their own areas of expertise, and they don't want to. He does it himself in this video, which is actually true, where he says that genetics aren't where some people think they are. In a accounting for the overall causation and risk factors. So I get that, you know. I'm not going to ascribe any particular motives to anyone other than I think it's just the result of people's conditioning. That's been, some people just view the world from this Newtonian nominalist viewpoint that's been around, that's been, what's the word, prominent for the last 500-600 years. So how do they don't know that there are people out there who view who viewed things completely differently and still do, and they just they see everything through that particular lens, and that's just, they're conditioned, and that's the popular viewpoint, and they don't see that they're starting the book in chapter 6 and they think they have a good grasp on the entire story, but they actually don't. So, and there are other people who understand that fundamentals are fundamental, and you just can't ignore fundamentals when you're building a house. And that's how they view, that's the lens they look through. And those two opposing conditions are still at odds 600 years later, 500-600 years later, and I don't see that ending anytime soon, except in the end, truth always becomes self-evident. And so that's another point. You don't need a supercomputer to begin to see that certain things are true and certain things are not true. And eventually consensus just bubbles up to the top. And that's pretty much what happened. That's pretty much what happened in the fecal transplant research. That's pretty much what happened in the WHO determining the hierarchical risk factors. And you didn't need a supercomputer to do that. You just needed reason and logic and the ability to condense a lot of information into its fundamental perspective, the fundamentals of the information. But that's where I am. So I'm just going to share this short from him and something that I created from AI and try to figure out how I'm going to keep this site relevant for the next year, because I keep ending up at this particular crossroads and I don't see that changing anytime soon. I'm not going to spend the time to edit things that simply are not true. I am not going to confuse people. But at the same time, there are some major developments that should be put out there and discussed. And that's just where it is. Fiber is becoming a buzzword of sorts, and that's not going to help the majority of people who have had this from birth and don't even realize it, because the damage has already been done. You aren't going to be able to extract the benefits from fiber because of that, and you have to address the foundational problems before fiber can be of any benefit to you whatsoever. So it's just babies don't eat fiber, and by the time they do eat fiber, this inherent condition is already established, and it doesn't reverse. That's the bottom line of that particular short, that clip of this video I'm going to share, because he reduces the, he at least ends the is it carbs, is it sugar debate. He at least ends that debate. So that's a bright side of the equation, but I don't know. That's just where it always ends up, and I don't quite know how to overcome it without just repeating my own, not even my own. It's not even, none of this is mine. If they didn't know it, I wouldn't know it. So, it's January. I should be looking forward to a new way to try to attract more people, and right back in the same old place I was last January. So other than that, I finally did put up a new recipe, and you can reduce the sugar a little bit more. But in the meantime, my takeaway message from him is that if you can keep it below 25 grams, that's how much you can properly metabolize without doing yourself any harm. And that is a crucial thing that needs to be addressed. And that is the average sugar consumption in not only the American culture, but the world culture today. So I'm just going to take away the good, and I'll see what happens next week. But that's all I have for this week. And that's where it always ends up. And I do not care to have to, I am not the editor of the world, and I prefer to keep things as simple and as direct and as fundamental as possible so that people can enact real change. And then, the other thing he said is that this will end up being an extremely individualized approach to correcting the microbiota of poor microbiota, and that is simply not true. It only takes a few components to change the initial setup, namely bifido would be the issues as you saw in last week's post, And then your microbiota transformation becomes individualized in conjunction with your own environment, your own diet, etc. So it adapts. It's adaptive. They already know this is adaptive. They already know it's environmentally adaptive. That's also been shown with migrating populations. So that part is simply not true. So I didn't feel like editing the last 2 minutes. So that's there, and that's not true. It's not going to take another 20 years before we determine every single microbe in the healthy donor microbiota to enact a specific result. That's simply not true. So, okay, that's my rant for the week, and it is what it is. I can't change anything. Okay, have a good one, everyone. I'll see you next time. Bye. Me again, as I was beginning to edit this video, I remembered a perfect example of where you are to this day, and that has to do with Sabin versus Salk, okay? You're still in the Salk corner. Sabin was correct. Sabin actually used colostrum and the majority who took his approach got their so-called vaccine orally. That's all I'm going to say. You're still in. It's a perfect illustration of the continental divide between effective, fundamental, and nominalist, material, modernist, Newtonian, however you would like to describe it. You're still in that, what's the word? You're still in that particular dichotomy, and that's a perfect example. Sabin versus Salk. Okay, have a good one, everyone. Bye.